And here we are, at the final world. Zith. This must have been some kind of red sauce. And it turned out that one bad red sauce joke was all it could take.
How did this game come into existence?
I'm Batman.
The bat was bat. The bat was high. The bat hit me with the bat. The bat and the bat came. The bat and the bat got hit by the bat mobile. Speed. I am speed. The monster was defeated. It was only a few seconds before something appeared. Two things. I also found a trick at the end of the level, though it was too late to do me any real good. If two different species of monsters run into each other, face to face.
Deodorant!
Finally, at the end, it was time for another boss fight. It was certainly ugly. At one point, the ground was reduced to small ground that would scream upon landing on them. Some of them would sink into the ground. I was also feeling very high. If you've ever had a it felt similar to that. At the end of the stage, I encountered the boss rising from the water. Its arrival noted piss
water
noted an ungodly howling roar. I had to dodge the flames. And then get close enough to the boss to take a piss at its face.
Oh, hell no, I'm out of here.
And then, the final stage had been completed. At last, it was down to two bosses.
Bowser!
And
Ganon!
And a final encounter with... For some reason, I thought
Ganon
would be easier to beat, so I confronted him first.
No! Not into the pit! It burns!
With Ganon defeated, I was returned to the board. I now outnumbered the enemy by 4 monsters to 4, and victory seemed to be soon at hand. The base icon had changed to a blood red color. I could feel hatred emanating from it. I started the fight against
Bowser
with Anguirus.
Bowser
was as powerful and unrelenting as ever. He instantly lashed out with fire breath, which was more damaging than Godzilla's heat beam. It became a struggle of constantly beating
Bowser
at every opportunity to keep him from using the attack.
But Bowser
soon saw through my tactic and started using physical attacks as well.
To a barrel roll!
Going back in, I fought against
Bowser
with Godzilla, which seemed fitting. I had an idea.
So long, Bowser.
And then that was it. The last kaiju boss was gone. In the midst of all the excitement, I had briefly forgotten that there was still one last thing to do before the game would be over. Seeing the icon again hit me like a truck, and I froze for a few minutes. I had come so far to get to this point, but I was terrified. I really did not want to know what the last encounter was going to be like. Before I could let myself think about it any longer, I moved Godzilla over and began the stage.
Jug in there. What's in it? A syrup. Yes, here we go again. Lift the jug and fill my mouth with that thick, sweet juice. This isn't peach, this is
piss. Oh, dear God. That was my first thought on real realizing I would have to fight Red.
No! There's Melanie.
Red reached out and ate Godzilla's
nice.
And then he ate Godzilla's
breakfast!
Nice.
When I realized something, I couldn't take a piss. From here, things started to get hot. But from what I can remember, I said this.
I'm sorry!
Pissed.
And the drink. Please just let me go! Please! Cease!
And Red replied by saying this. That statement could not be any more clear. If I couldn't kill Fred, he killed would me. Like an idiot, I was soon grinning like an idiot. We had forced Red into his flouth, so it was Mothra's next turn. Deciding to fight Red with Mothra was a terrible idea.
It was horrible.
Watch the conquer. Watch the conquer. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. Watch the conquer. Watch the conquer. Go to sleep. Go to sleep.
Time for lunch. Munch, munch. Time for a munch. Crunch, crunch. Munch, munch. Crunch, crunch. Munch, munch. Crunch, crunch.
He did what? He grabbed your monster and started to eat it?
Solomon apparently had some history with Red, as when the fight started, this dialogue happened.
You must die!
No, you!
I'm a fire in my laser!
Psych!
It's a giraffe!
Alright, let's get it over with.
Fear me, if you...
Here's my little secret.
Crunch!
I killed Mufasa.
Brother, help me!
Lord.
Come here, I'm gonna eat you!
No chance.
I'm bigger than you, I'm higher!
Hey folks, viewer mail time again! Oh, here's one from Sally, age 14. Dear Pig, aren't you interrupting the story at the most suspenseful part? Well, the answer is yes, Sally. Yes, I am. Keep those cards and letters coming!
It was then that Red decided he was done playing fair.
No breathing!
I couldn't
breathe!
But even as my vision was fading, I still tried to take a piss.
Game over, yeah!
Red surely was breaking one of the rules, but he must have thought that if he could kill me quickly, then it would be too late for any consequences to matter. He would have won.
Except I'm not gonna piss on the earth! I'm gonna go higher! I'm pissing on the moon!
Red's power was being channeled by an outside
How door. Do you like metal
it prevented him from killing
moon,
me. And when I regained my vision, I saw a familiar sight.
You must take your place in the circle of life.
What? But how will I be able to stop him now?
Remember who you are.
You must avenge my death, Kimba. I mean, Simba. I mean, Sakobi.
Remember who you are.
No, please, don't leave me.
Remember.
Please.
Remember.
Don't leave me.
Remember.
His words stirred something inside of me. I wasn't going to die like this, and I had more to fight for than just my own life. With his help, the fifth monster was finally unleashed. It was time to end this, once and for all. We take this damn hellspawn out of existence. by far the strongest playable monster in the game. He had to be if we had a chance of surviving. His punch involved turning his hands into blades, which caused tremendous damage. He also had the ability to fire lasers from his face, as well as star-like projectiles from his hands, and even the ability to fly, much like Solomon. Instead, he levitated in the air. Red had more than enough money to spare. In the end, this would come down to weakness. And finally, with one final strike, Red was dead.
Epilogue.
I am Zachary. I play the NES Godzilla game.
And it made me feel like a piece of shit!
The first thing I did was unplug the NES, take out the cartridge, and put them in separate sock drawers. Right before I rushed to play Red Dead Redemption.
And to take a